job. Shifting gears here, he was promoting parties at 15 years old and owned his own nightclub at the age of 22. Yes, 22.
An entrepreneur's dream. And now native Memphian Kobe Randolph is writing about his success in his book, The Champagne Life. I tell you what, how did you just always do something of your own, want to build something of your own? 15 is so young to just say, you know what, I'm going to be in charge. I'm going to run my own thing.
Well, 2 weeks before I turned 15, I had a job at Chili's for 2 weeks and I hated it. And I said, there has to be a better life. This cannot be life.
So that kind of got the ball rolling. You had the ripe old age of 14,
yes,
soon to be 15.
Yes, I mean, something about cleaning out the girls' restrooms at Chili's on Winchester
just didn't do it for me.
I'll tell you.
Showing up at a certain time, having to say a certain number of hours, and working for somebody else's dream, huh?
I didn't understand. This is America. It couldn't be life. So, I knew that there had to be something that I could do that wasn't illegal, and I could still make a good living, and I could set my own schedule. And then there was this thing called entrepreneurship, and I talked to my father about it and my parents, and I told him this idea of I wanted to throw parties. But honestly, throwing parties was an expensive industry. I mean, when I was in high school, I remember having to save up $1,500 to risk it all in one night.
Right, mm-hmm. Because you have to rent the place,
you have to get the music. Radio advertising, you know, it was just expensive. And they said, well, why don't you do something here at the house, small, and we'll see how it works. So I said, okay, great.
Wow, what
so how
great
did that, how did that go so far?
Well, about 250 people showed up when I did it at the house.
Did that freak everybody out, including your folks?
I think it freaked them out, and then a light bulb went off and said, hey, we may have something here.
We could make some money.
Yeah, and so that's how it actually started.
What about when you made the transition over to Tennessee State University as well?
Yes, and here's the thing. I had offers to go to different colleges. Yeah. I looked at Morehouse. I looked at Howard. I looked at UT Knox. I looked at Yale. But here's the thing. My main decision on going to college was how can I launch my business here, a platform, launch my business. So not only did I go to the financial aid office and I go to the business school, but I also went to the radio station to see what all on-air jockeys they had. I looked at how many DJs were in the city. I knew I wanted to own a nightclub. Who are the nightclubs in the city? And Nashville happened to be the perfect place in the perfect untapped market to launch my business. And I solely made my decision off of that.
To say the least, you really did your homework. You really did it well.
It wasn't just about what the dorms looked like or what the academic credits per dollar were at all. That is so cool. So you get to college. I know you went to class. You were a good student. But it sounds like you spent an equal amount of time building your own empire, if you will, your own future.
Definitely. And I think what a lot of my peers didn't realize was really the sacrifices. I didn't get the opportunity to be in a fraternity.
Right.
A lot of on-campus organizations, I didn't get the opportunity. I gave up playing football, which mm-hmm. was one of my original reasons of going there once I realized I wasn't going to the NFL. So,
You had a future to build.
Yes.
And you missed parties yourself.
I missed a lot, even though
you were throwing parties, that's a work.
That was work. And yeah. I gave up a lot to sacrifice and just keep my mind on the goal. And here I am.
I do have to ask you very quickly. You've had a chance to hang out with some of the folks. Let me just make sure I don't leave some of the folks out. Diddy, Lil Wayne, Russell Simmons, Taraji P. Henson, just to name a few.
Yeah.
What's that been like? And also your alter ego that a lot of us know a little about there as well.
Yes. Well, some of these first encounters took place even still while I was in high school.
Wow.
And we're talking about a situation where I gave up going on my senior trip to fly out to Los Angeles to meet someone.
Wow.
Because I was in such fear. My parents always told me, now when you're 18, you cut off. So people, what you want to do. And especially as a parent hearing their son say, I want to go into the world of entertainment.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You know, with both of them practicing medicine, it was scary. So here it is. I was 18 years old. It's time to go on a senior trip. And I said, guys, I'm not going. I'm going to Los Angeles. And I fly out to Los Angeles to an award show that I really don't even know how I'm going to get in. Mm-hmm. And I finagle my way through. And I run into some of these people you just mentioned. And then they accepted me, and the light bulb went off. I said, oh, man, they think I'm one of them. And I was able to network my way through the ranks. And, you know, the thing is that really my message is, and it's worked in those situations when I was in high school. I didn't know what it was called. But at 22, at 24 now, I know that it's the perception, your perception of yourself is the world's reality. Mm-hmm. And so many of us set limitations on ourselves, and we wait on to get this degree or to get this nomination before we realize the thing that is driving our success always has lied within you.
Always inside.
Always inside.
How can there's someone out there on the couch wanting to meet you and pick your brain. How can they meet you this weekend?
Well, this weekend, it's a great weekend. Like I said, I'm back home, and tonight, actually, I'll be at the Westin, right downtown across from FedEx Forum, and I'll have my book reception and book signing at 8:30 to 11:30. So I'll be there.
You know, it's a perfect time for entrepreneurship.
Yeah, it is, right there.
Absolutely.
Want to take that off the screen right there, but The Champagne Life is the name of the book. Yep. Toby, thank you very much, man.
Thank
glad
you so
to have you back.
It's been a pleasure.
Home.
Thank you. It's great to be back home.
You
the
come
Champagne
back.
Life.
Definitely.
All right, a short break here. We'll be back with more live at 9:00.